Clay targets are made to be destroyed the very first time they're used. Manufactured in multiple colors, these inverted saucers are used as practice targets and can be launched by hand or through automated machines. Also referred to as clay pigeons, these targets are not actually made of clay. They're made with pitch, a ceramic-type material, or resin. Since the 1920s, this French company has been producing clay saucers for both target practice and competitions, including the Olympics. The founder invented the first automated target molding machine in 1947. Pitch targets are made from petroleum pitch, a substance derived from crude oil, and calcium carbonate, commonly known as talc. Talc is the filler, while petroleum pitch is the binding agent, which solidifies into a hard, brittle material. The talc arrives to the factory heated at 176 degrees Fahrenheit. A technician transfers the talc from the truck to a heated storage silo. A screw conveyor moves the talc from the silo to the blender tank, mixing it with the pitch. The petroleum pitch arrives to the factory heated to 392 degrees. The pitch is transferred to a heated storage silo and pumped into a blender. Every 10 seconds, 22 pounds of petroleum pitch and 64 pounds of talc are released into the blender. The materials cool as soon as they leave the heated silos. A gas boiler reheats the ingredients in 509-degree oil. The hot oil circulates in pipes around the blender, heating the pitch talc mixture to about 390 degrees. This process changes the consistency to a paste. The paste flows from the blender to the automatic molding machine. This valve cuts the flow at regular intervals to time the injections into the target-shaped molds. The machine compresses the paste while cooling it with water so that it solidifies. A transfer device moves the targets onto a conveyor belt one at a time. As they move to the next conveyor belt, the molds are flipped right side up. Even though the molds are still hot, they've remained soft and pliable. As the targets continue to cool and harden, a separating device lines them up for the conveyor belts that go to the paint chambers. The paint is made primarily of carbonate and biodegradable powdered pigment. A technician pours a pre-measured amount of water and a bag of pigment into a mixer. The mixer combines the ingredients together. Once the water and pigment have blended together, a pre-measured amount of carbonate is added to the mixer, along with a binding and thickening agent. After additional blending, the paint is ready. The targets move from the conveyor belt onto spinning holders, which carry the targets through the paint chamber. Inside, a sprayer coats the spinning targets with paint. The targets exit the chamber wet and cooled. Another separator divides the targets onto two conveyor belts, which carry them through a hot air tunnel for 30 seconds to dry the paint. The conveyor belt feeds the targets to a machine, which piles them in stacks. Clay pigeons can be manufactured in several sizes. Olympic regulation size is the largest, containing a width of 4 inches. A smaller target is used for training purposes and contains a width under 4 inches. Regardless of their size, all targets are engineered to remain stable in flight while following the intended trajectory, and finally, shatter when shot.